Hey guys, it's Alachia, and this is my review for Saltburn. As you can see, I have dressed up in the theme of this gothic fantasy, which is written and directed by Emerald Fennell and starring Barry Keoghan, Jacob Elordi, Rosamund Pike, and Richard E. Grant. It is a tale of a young Oxford student who finds himself very alone and isolated from other students. And he ends up befriending an aristocratic student named Felix Catton, played by Jacob Elordi, who is beautiful and rich and popular. And he becomes infatuated with him. And this tale kind of explores his infatuation with Felix and then subsequently with the rest of his very eccentric family. And the trailers, I was very drawn to the trailer because it has that stylistic sense of a giant mystery box that you're not sure if you open up Pandora's box, you know, are you going to get, you know, all the wonders and delights, or are you going to get something tragic and horrifying, right? And that's kind of like where the movie keeps you, and just the sense of like, what have we opened up here, right? And my God, I don't want to give any spoilers away, because I think that if you have a remote interest in seeing this film and you like the idea of a story which kind of subverts the themes of obsession and desire and kind of explores the twisted Alice in Wonderland journey, I think you should go see this in the theaters without knowing much about it other than what you see in the trailers, because there are just pieces of this film that I think should be seen with other people, because it becomes almost like an event. The discovery and the revelations, and as the story unfolds, as the layers peel back, and you get to see more and more behind the opulence and the absurdity of the opulence and the discomfort you start to experience while still having morbid curiosity, is very much worthwhile to see how other people also react to it. That's all I really want to say without going more into it, because I don't want to give it away. I just think it's worth going and having that experience with other people in the audience, because you'll never, ever get that viewing this at home by yourself. So I highly, highly recommend you go to the theaters to see this, because not only is it beautiful, not only is it the scope and the scale, Linus Sandgren, the cinematographer, filmed this at a 1:33:1 ratio, which at first I was like, wait, you're kidding me, like we're not going widescreen? But it for some reason does work, in the fact that it does make the film feel a little bit more intimate, and you almost feel like you're looking through a peephole, and which I think works towards, you know, how you're supposed to be digesting this film, as if you're watching all of this like very uncomfortable decadence and world be unfolded to you that you're not really supposed to be watching. Although I will say, because the sets and the production was so elaborate, and does not disappoint, I did almost kind of wish it was widescreen so I could see more of it, right? It is filmed at the Drayton House in Northamptonshire, and that's a house that no one else has ever filmed on, or an estate that no one else has ever filmed on, and I don't think anyone ever will again, because the owners are just like, yes, you can use this house, but no one is allowed to ever reveal the location of this house, and no one's ever allowed to reveal who the owners of this place are. And I'm just like, wow, well, yeah, that's the type of film this is. And so when you're watching it and you're going through this grand, massive estate and all these people are just over the top, excess, dripping with absolute just vanity and opulence that that sort of disgusts you and then makes you kind of laugh at absolutely how disgusting it is. It's fabulous. The humor in it is just so biting, and the way she wrote it, there were just lines that were dropped so subtly that it slips out of their mouth and it takes you a while to process it, and you're just like, did she just say, God, did she just say that? That's hilarious. And I think a lot of the dialogue is like that, where it's so subtle that it's not one of those ka-ching moments where you're like, oh yeah, that's a funny line. It's done with such sincerity and conviction from the characters that you can't even believe it's coming out of their mouth. Like I said, the script is just so clever. And the performances, oh my God, Barry Keoghan, step up and get your freaking Oscar. I just got through saying how in The Holdovers, I thought Paul Giamatti definitely may deserve the best leading actor Oscar win. No. By a mile, by miles and miles, or kilometers in this case, Barry Keoghan, holy crap. His performance alone is worth seeing this for. It's absolutely incredible, top to bottom, from every little ounce of his eye movement, like the tiniest microscopic things about his performance. You're just absolutely captivated in his range and what he's, you know, able to do and give the character of Oliver Quick that just has you just constantly so drawn in. You're just to the point where you're like, I can't, oh God, oh wow, you know? That's the type of performance that just makes you feel things. And then Jacob Elordi, second film I've seen this year where he's just done a marvelous job. He definitely deserves a Best Supporting Actor nomination, especially after this. He brings you into this world, and he is basically like your travel guide into this absolute disgusting world of excess. And he's so charming about it. And he just, the delivery is just so warm and inviting. And I just thought it was absolutely captivating. And then Rosamund Pike, Best Actress nomination, has to be, Best Supporting Actress nomination. She is perfect. The perfect role for her. Her delivery is just perfection. It could not have been any more perfect. I absolutely love this film, as you can tell, and I want people to go out and see it in the theaters. You know, I hardly recommend going out into the theaters, because I really feel like exploring this film and being a voyeur to this world and this story with other people really gains you a little bit extra in terms of your experience of watching this film. I'm going to give Saltburn an A+. I know, I can't even believe it myself. If I'm probably gonna like think back later, I'll probably be like, oh, there's a couple of plot moments where I'm just like, I don't care. There may be moments where you're just like, could have worked. That's fine. You know what? I loved every minute of being in this film, of being able to, you know, be the fly on the wall, getting to watch something I think I should not have seen. You know, it's like you have the privilege to see something and you're like, am I supposed to be watching this? Like, but I can't stop watching it. I just love being able to had that experience, especially in the theater with other people. This film is not for everyone, though. You got to be a little twisted. You can't be a normie and go see this film. There's got to be a little part of you that's a little twisty, little wicked and twisty, in order for you to enjoy this film. But if you are, oh boy, you're gonna love it. I was actually surprised this film even got made. I was thinking, how did they sell this? How did the producers sell this package? Because who would have given money for her to, you know, only a two-time film director and writer this story in particular and be like, yeah, let's make that film. And I was like, wow, those producers must have been amazing at getting this like putting that package together and going like, yeah, you know, you guys want to produce, you know, you guys want to put money into this film. Turns out it is produced by Lucky Chap Productions or Lucky Chap Entertainment, which is Margot Robbie and her husband and their friends' production company. So I think that's probably why this actually was able to happen, because otherwise I was just thinking like, who would ever allow this, right? It's that level of like, this is not something you can just sell, you know, like it's so outrageous. You're just like, who's going to buy this? Who's going to fund this? And yet it is so well put together. The cast is extraordinary. The delivery is extraordinary. The production is extraordinary. The film quality, the cinematography is just, it's just all sweet, 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 disgusting candy. And so, yeah. Please go see this in the theaters if you are sick and twisty like me. And let me know what you guys thought. I am going to be doing a spoiler breakdown. There were moments where I just was like, oh, I want to explain this film by saying it is a merger of this film and this film together. Or even like, oh, kind of like this book. You know, I think Brideshead Revived is the one that a lot of people are like, oh, it's based off of that. I was like, eh, yeah, there are things that are drawn from those types of stories. But It's a story on its own. And so I don't want to say anything. All right, guys, let me know what you guys thought of Saltburn, if you've seen it. Very excited to discuss this later. And thanks so much for watching. And if you'd like to watch more, you can click right here to watch more now. Until next time, see you on the flip side. Boom, 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 boom